Welcome to first lecture on DC circuits. We are going to learn today the basic terminologies used in DC circuits and notations that we are going to follow. Let us begin with the Ohm's law. Just try to explain the statement of Ohm's law. At constant temperature, the potential difference between the ends of the conductor is proportional to the current flowing to the conductor. Mathematically, the Ohm's law can be stated as V is proportional to I. The constant of proportionality can be indicated as R. Therefore, V can be replaced by I into R, where R is known as constant of proportionality. It is known as resistance of the conductor. Extending the theory of Ohm's law for n resistors when they are connected in series and try to determine the equivalent resistance of the series combination. So, resistors are connected in series. Referring to the diagram number 1, n resistors are connected in the series manner across the V volt supply in a series network. Current through R1, current through R2, or current through the Rn resistor, it is same. Current it is same. Total voltage applied is equal to summation of the individual resistor drop. Therefore, in series network, total voltage applied V should be equal to V1 plus V2 till Vn. By Ohm's law, V1 is equal to I into R1 and V2 is I into R2 and Vn is I into Rn. You can call this as equation number 1. Referring to the diagram number 2, total voltage applied is equal to I into Rs, where Rs is equivalent resistance of the series combination. From equation number 1 and 2, equation one, it is dimensionally equal to equation two, I into RS should be equal to I into R one, I into R two till I into RN. Therefore, equivalent resistance of the series combination is equal to summation of the individual resistor values. RS should be equal to R one plus R two till RN. Extend the theory of Ohm's law when n resistors are connected in parallel. Try to determine equivalent resistance of the parallel combination. Referring to the figure number one, n resistors are connected in parallel across the V volt supply. In a parallel network, voltage is same, but total current supplied from the source should be equal to the summation of the individual current. Therefore, referring to the diagram number or figure number one, in parallel network, voltage is same. And total current I should be equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 till IN. But what is I1 means? V by R1. I2 is V by R2. And IN is V by RN. You can call this as equation number one. Referring to the diagram number two or figure number two, total I should be equal to V divided by RP. From equation number 1 and 2, two equations are going to be balanced dimensionally. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, V by RP should be equal to V divided by R1, V divided by R2 till V divided by RN. 1 by RP should be equal to 1 by R1, 1 by R2 till 1 by RN. Reciprocal of the equivalent resistance of the parallel combination is equal to sum of the reciprocal of individual resistors. Preferably, try to get the expression for power in a DC network. Symbolic notation used for representing the power is P, is the symbolic notation. Power is equal to V into I, where V is the voltage, I is taken as the current. By Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, IR into I is equal to I square R. Expression for current in DC circuit, it is V by R, therefore you can express the equation for power as V square by R. So therefore, power equation can be expressed in terms of voltage and current, or you can express that power as I square R or V square by R. Unit of power, it is expressed in watts formula. Ohm's law is applicable for solving the simple problems. If the problem is numerically complex, provided the many sources with the many closed loops, preferably go for Kirchhoff's losses. So, when you are discussing the Kirchhoff's losses, there will be one is related to the current, second one is related to the voltage. There is first law, it is known as Kirchhoff's current law, second one is known as Kirchhoff's voltage law. Try to express or try to explain the statement and explanation related to the Kirchhoff's losses. So the next part is KCL and KVL. State and explain Kirchhoff's losses. The first law, it is known as Kirchhoff's current law, or it is also named as node law, junction law, or point law. Second one is taken as Kirchhoff's voltage law or mesh law or loop law. State the Kirchhoff's current law. In any linear active network, the algebraic sum of the currents meeting at a node is zero. For the KCL explanation, preferably take a two mesh problem with the three resistors which are in turn connected to the common point. That common point can be named as A, which is in turn energized by two sources E1 and E2. Node it is taken as, for in the given problem, A is taken as the node where two or more branch elements meet. R1, R2 and R3 resistors are there connected to the common point. That common point, it is known as node or junction, or it is known as point. When you are writing the Kirchhoff's current law equation for the given problem, step number one is mark the branch current. I1 is taken as the branch current flowing to the R1 resistor. I2 is taken as the branch current flowing to the R2 resistor. If the number of closed loops independently for the given problem is two independent loops, preferably make the number of unknown current only for two. Therefore, current flowing to the R1 resistor is I1, current flowing to the R2 resistor is I2, current flowing to the R3 resistor is, try to express the third current in terms of first two. branch current, it is physical current, it is the practical current, it is the true current, or it is the actual current flowing to the each resistor. And you are focusing on the node A. The current which is entering the node, it is taken as I1. The current which is entering the node A, it is taken as I2. The current which is leaving the node, it is taken as I1 plus I2. And incoming currents are always assigned with the positive sign convention. When the current is, when it is leaving the node, outgoing current, it is marked with the negative sign convention. When you are writing the KCL equation at node A, incoming current, it is I1. It is assigned with the positive sign convention. Current which is independently entering that node, it is I2. The current which is leaving the node, it is I1 minus I2. Equated to the zero value. For the same problem, you can state the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Then try to write the KVL equation for the given problem. By writing the KVL equation, normally we are solving for the branch currents. So therefore, we'll state the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Or it is also named as mesh law. In any linear active network, the algebraic sum of the voltage drops or IR drops plus EMFs taken around the closed mesh is zero. For the selected problem, step number one is mark the branch currents. Step number two is mark the polarity. Mark the polarity, as current it is always flowing from positive terminal, current flows from the higher potential and current leaving terminal, it is indicated by the negative polarity. I2 current, it is entering through the R2 resistor at the higher potential and it is leaving at the lower potential. I1 plus I2 current, it is entering through the R3 resistor at the higher potential and current leaving terminal, it is taken as minus. The number of unknowns in the given problem, it is two unknown currents, namely I1 and I2. Solve for the two unknown currents, I1 and I2, by writing the voltage equation for the two independent loops, DA, BC, D, and AE, FB, A. Select the closed loop DA, BC, D. when you are writing the equation, Kirchhoff's voltage law equation from D to A, we are moving from higher potential to the lower potential in the direction of current. Whenever there is a flow of current to the any resistor, it creates potential drop. I1 current, it flows to the R1 resistor from plus terminal to minus terminal. I1 R1, it is a ohmic drop. Potential drop, it is always assigned with the negative sign convention. Similarly, from A to B, if you travel, you are moving from plus to minus. Higher potential to the lower potential, it always creates the potential drop. Branch current, it is I1 plus I2. Branch resistor is R3, but it's the potential drop. B to C, we cannot find the any circuit element. If we travel from C to D, we are moving from minus to plus. Lower potential to the higher potential, it creates always potential rise. Rise in potential, it is always assigned with the positive sign convention, equated to the zero value. This is the statement of KVL, summation of the IR drops plus EMFs taken around the closed mesh or closed loop is zero. Try to express the equation, rearrange the term and try to get the equation for E1, that is I1 into R1 plus R3, I2 R3 should be equal to plus E1. The equation number one for closed loop DA, BC, D. On the similar lines, you write KVL equation for the closed loop AE, FB, A. A to E, we are moving from lower potential to the higher potential, direction opposite to the current, it always creates the potential rise. Minus to plus becomes potential rise. Rise in potential, it is always assigned with the positive sign convention. E to F, we are moving from plus to minus, it is minus E2. F to B, you will not find any circuit element. If you travel from B to A, minus to plus, it is a potential rise. Branch current, it is I1 plus I2. Branch resistor is R3, equated to the zero value. Simplify the equation, rearrange the term I1 R3 plus I2 times R2 plus R3 should be equal to plus C2. Solve for the two simultaneous equation and solve for the branch currents I1 and I2. From equation number 1 and 2, solve for the branch currents I1 and I2. This completes the statement and the explanation for KVL. Based on KCL and KVL, we are going to work the few problems. The problem number one is, actually adu no scan madbeku actually kodbeka
editing al mad
right, no problem. Numerical problems on no problem. Numerical problems on DC circuits. Problem number one. Question is, determine subdivision one, all the branch currents subdivision 2, current at node D and its direction and subdivision 3, PD between the terminals A and D for the network shown. So the network it is given. This is a given network. Your aim is to measure the branch current IAB, IBC, ICD, IDE, IEF, IFA. And for the subdivision 2, try to determine the magnitude of the current at node D and its direction. And the last part of the problem is measure the potential difference between A and the D terminal. Now, the number of unknowns for the given problem, it is 6 unknown currents, IAB, IBC, ICD, IDE, IEF and IFA. Before attempting the numerical, you can focus on the subdivision 2, current at node D and its direction. Inward arrows are always representing the generation, outward arrows are always indicating the load. For the given practical system, total load should be always met by the total generation. Therefore, total generation should be equal to total load. Try to focus on the each node. At node A, you are able to get the inward current. Current when it is entering the node, inward current it is indicated as generation, it is 80 amperes. Current which is entering the node C, it is taken as the 60 ampere current. Once again, it is the generation. 70 ampere current, it is entering the node E. It should be always balanced by the outgoing current, or it is known as loads only. At node D, magnitude of the current which is leaving the node, it is 60 amperes. Magnitude of the current which is leaving the node F, it is 30 amperes. For balancing the equation dimensionally, I have to add one more extra term in the right hand side, because if you add all the three currents with the inward current, total value becomes 210 amperes on the right hand side. You got only 90 amperes. Therefore, one more current should be added at node D. That current can be named as I suffix D. Therefore, magnitude of I suffix D current, it is taken as 120 amperes. So therefore, for subdivision number 2, current at node D is 120 amperes, but it is a load. Therefore, arrow direction for the current at node D should be outward, whose magnitude should be equal to 120 amperes. Therefore, current at node D will be, subdivision 2 is, current at node D is 120 amperes and it is flowing away from the node D. When the current at node D is evaluated, we are answering for the first subdivision of the problem. For solving for the branch current, you got the freedom to assume any one of the branch current through the network. Current flowing to the AB terminal of the network can be called as some I. What is I? We don't know. There is an unknown current. Try to satisfy the Kirchhoff's current law at each node. We are given the convention, incoming current, it is always assigned with the positive sign convention. And the current, when it is leaving the node, outward current, it is indicated by the negative sign convention. Therefore, branch current flowing to the BC part of the network is incoming current, it is I, outgoing current, it is 60. Therefore, branch current through the BC path, it is I minus 60. Current at node D is I minus 60 ampere current it is entering, 60 will be added. So therefore, total current when it is flowing to the CD branch, it is I minus 60. For that, you can add another 60, it becomes just I. At node D, if you satisfy the KCL condition, incoming current it is I, 120 ampere it is leaving. Therefore, branch current through the DE path, it is I minus 120. Satisfy the KCL condition at node E, incoming current it is I minus 120, 70 will be added. Therefore, net current or branch current flowing to the EF path is I minus 120 it is entering, 70 will be added. Therefore, this branch current becomes I minus 50. At node F, if you satisfy the KCL condition, incoming current is I minus 50, 30 it is leaving. Therefore, branch current it is I minus 50 minus 30, I minus 80. For that, if you add another 80, you will get the same current of I. So therefore, for the given problem, we have marked the branch currents I minus 60, I minus 120, I minus 50, I minus 80. Only one current it is unknown in the network is I. When there is a single unknown in the problem, you can write one KVL equation for the closed loop A, B, C, D, E, F, A. So therefore, we are going to find one single closed loop, loop A, B, C, D, E, F, A. If you travel from A to B, we are moving in the direction of current. In the direction of current, it always creates the ohmic drop. Branch resistor is 0.02, branch current it is I, but it is a drop. Branch resistance is 0.02, I, it is a drop. If you travel from B to C, branch current is I minus 60, branch resistor is 0.01, it is a ohmic drop. C to D, branch current is I, branch resistor is 0.03, it is a drop. D to E, if you travel, branch current is I minus 120, branch resistor is 0.01, it is a drop. E to F, if you travel, branch current is I minus 50, branch resistance is 0.01, it is a drop. The last branch, it is F to A, branch current is I minus 80, branch resistor is 0.02 equated to the zero value. Now simplify the equation. 0.1i should be equal to minus of minus 0.6, minus of minus 1.2, minus of minus 0.5. So therefore 0.1i is equal to 3.9, therefore value of I current becomes 39 amperes. So branch current through AB path it is measured already as 39 amperes. Substitute the value of I in the each expression and solve for the first subdivision. Therefore, subdivision 1 is branch currents are IAB, it is same as ICD, numerical it is equal to 39 amperes. Then IBC current is IBC current is, as per the diagram, it is I minus 60. Substitute for I as 39, 39 minus 60 is minus 21 amperes, or C to B current is plus 21. E to D to E current is I minus 120. Substitute for I as 39 minus 120, it is minus 81 amperes. E to F current is I minus 50, 39 minus 50, minus 11 amperes. And F to A current, it is I minus 80, 39 minus 80, minus 41 amperes. This is the first subdivision of the problem. And the last subdivision of the problem is, determine the voltage drop between the terminals A and D. So when you are measuring the potential difference between A and D, preferably travel from D to C, C to B, B to A, or D to E, E to F, F to A. Whenever you are measuring the potential difference between A to D, always you feel A is at higher potential compared to D. Physically travel from D to A. So therefore, VAD potential is, I am moving direction opposite to the current from D to C. Branch resistor is 0.03, branch current is I. Therefore, 0.03 into I, direction opposite to the current, it creates the rise. Then C to B, if you travel direction opposite to the current, branch current is I minus 60, branch resistor is 0.01. So B to A, if you travel, you are moving direction opposite to the current. Once again, it creates the potential rise, 0.02 times I. So therefore, VAD potential is 0.03 times I. Then C to B will be I minus 60, I minus 60 into 0.01. And B to A will be 0.02 times I. Substitute for the I value and simplify. 0.03 times 39 plus 39 minus 60 times 0.01 plus 0.02 times 39. So if we simplify the equation, this comes to 1.95, this becomes 0.21, you will be able to get 1.74 volts. Similarly, we can solve for the second problem, that is problem number 2. Question is, ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ಔಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಇದು. ನೋಡೋಣ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಅದು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ? Find the difference of potential between the points X and Y for the network shown. For measuring the voltage between X and Y, preferably travel from Y to X. Preferably travel from Y to X. Or preferably travel from Y to X. So maybe that this is the least possible path for the problem. Your aim is to measure the potential difference between the X and Y terminal. So now, for the simplification of the problem, preferably disconnect the source, which is connected between the terminals A and B. Then mark the branch current for the first closed loop in the direction of source. I1 is taken as the branch current which is flowing to the given resistor of 3 ohms and it is leaving. The same I1 current it is entering through the 2 ohm resistor and it is leaving. And the similar way you can mark the one more branch current as I2. This 4 volt source it is driving the current in the BY direction. The current it is entering. Current entry point it is always assigned with the positive sign convention. It gives only one information. Current flows always from the higher potential and it is leaving at the lower potential level. Same current it passes through the 5 ohm resistor and it is leaving. Now current quantities are marked in the direction of current. Therefore I can write the KVL equation for the simple mesh in the direction of current. So therefore minus to plus becomes potential rise plus 2. I1 current it is entering from the positive terminal and it is leaving at the lower potential 3 times I1. Plus to minus it is 2 times I1 equated to the 0 value. Therefore I1 is equal to 2 by 5 or 0.4 amperes. Referring to the second loop in the direction of current, if you write the KVL equation, you are moving from minus to plus. Plus 4. I2 current it is entering and it is leaving, therefore it becomes 3 times I2. Current it is entering and it is leaving 5 times I2 equated to the 0 value. Therefore 8 I2 is equal to 4, I2 is equal to half amperes. Once if you calculate I1 and I2 current, preferably introduce the source which was disconnected earlier between the terminal A and B. Now your aim is to measure the potential difference between the point X and Y, preferably travel from Y to X. If you travel from Y to B, minus to plus, it becomes potential rise. Current through this resistor is I2, branch resistance is 3, it is a potential rise. Rise in potential, it is always assigned with the positive sign convention. B to A, if you travel, you are moving from plus to minus, minus 4. Higher potential to the lower potential. If you travel from A to X, plus to minus, it is a drop. Branch current is I1, branch resistor is 3, it is 3 times I1. Substitute for the I1 current and I2 current in the expression and simplify. It is 3 times 0.5 minus 4 minus 3 times 0.4. If you simplify the equation, you are able to get the answer as minus 3.7 volts. Potential difference between the point X and Y is minus 3.7 volts. What is the inference means? X is at negative potential compared to Y. If you want to retain the positive answer, you can write or VYX should be equal to 3.7 volts. Therefore, when X is negative with respect to Y, Y should be positive with respect to X. Just you can change the polarity as 3.7 volts. Now this completes your second problem. We are moving to the third variety problem. Question number 3, problem number 3, determine I and R for the circuit shown. The potential drop across the 15 ohm resistor, it is given that as 30 volts. Therefore, current flowing through the 15 ohm branch will be 30 volts divided by 50. The current flowing through the 15 ohm resistor, it is same as current delivered by the 100 volt source. Therefore, if you call this resistor as some R1, if you name this voltage as V1, what is current delivered by the source means you can name this current as I1. What is I1 means I1 current is simply V1 by R1. Voltage across the resistor is 30, branch resistance is 15, branch current becomes 2 amperes. Therefore, if you apply the Kirchhoff's current law at this node, at node A, incoming current it is 2 ampere, one more current which is entering the node it is 5 ampere, therefore branch current flowing to the AB path it is I1 plus 5, that is 2 amperes plus 5 amperes, put together it is 7 amperes. So therefore, what is IAB means? One incoming current it is taken as 5 amperes, second ampere current it is 2 ampere, it is 5 plus 2, 7 amperes. Resistor R and resistance 15 ohm, it is connected in series with the source. Current delivered by the 100 volt source, if it is I1 ampere current, current collected by the negative terminal of the battery should be I1 ampere only. Therefore, current flowing through this resistor is once again equal to I1. It will take the different path, but current collected by the negative terminal of the battery should be equal to the current delivered by the positive terminal. Positive terminal delivers I1 current. Current collected by the negative terminal of the battery should be I1. Therefore, if we apply KCL condition at node B, incoming current it is 7 amperes. What is IAB means? IAB means it is equal to I1. One more current which is leaving the node, it is 2 amperes. The third current which is leaving the node, it is I amperes. But IAB, it is already known, 7 ampere. I1 current we know, it is 2 amperes plus 2 plus I. Therefore, unknown current I given in the problem is 3 amperes. Once if you know the value of I, your aim is to measure the value of unknown resistor R. For that you can apply KVL condition for the closed loop AB, CD, A. A to B, if you travel plus to minus, it is minus 7 into 5, it is a drop. If you travel from plus to minus, I1 into R, I1 is 2, R we don't know. C to D, if you travel, you are moving from minus to plus, it is a potential rise plus 100. Plus to minus becomes drop, minus V1 or minus 30 volts equated to the zero value. Therefore, 2R is equal to 35, R is equal to 17.5 ohms. This is the solution for the problem number 3. And the similar way, we can go to the fourth variety problem. Fourth problem. Question is, determine subdivision 1, the value of or the values of E1 and E2, the current supplied by E2 source, load voltage or terminal voltage. For the network shown. The power dissipated by five ohm resistor is 125 watts, and current supplied by 1 source is 2 amperes. This is the given network. Given the two mesh problem, your aim is to measure the voltage across 5 ohm resistor, the values of E1 and E2 and I2. The first part of the question is determine E1 and E2, current supplied by the E2 source, that is I2 current, and load voltage or terminal voltage near the resistor. Step number one is mark the branch current. I1 is the branch current which is marked through the near the E1 source, that current it is entering and it is leaving. I2 current it is entering and it is leaving. This can be selected as one node where you can find two branch currents are going to meet. One is I1, second current it is I2. The current which is leaving the node is I1 plus I2. That current it is entering through the 5 ohm resistor and it is leaving. Now the number of unknowns for the given problem is E1 and E2. Number of equations required to solve for the problem is 2 equations. Preferably indicate the 2 meshes AB, CD, EF. Now you can write the KVL equation maybe for the outer mesh AB, EF, A. You are given the closed loop AB, EF, A. A to B, if you travel, you are moving from minus to plus, it is a potential rise plus C1. Plus to minus becomes potential drop, 1 ohm is the resistor, 2 ampere is the current. Plus to minus, it becomes once again the ohmic drop, it is 5 times I1 plus I2 equated to the zero value. But you can solve for the I2 current on the simple means, because power dissipated by 5 ohm resistor is 125 watts. Therefore, I1 plus I2 whole square times 5 is equal to 125. Therefore, I1 plus I2 is equal to 125 divided by 5 under the root sign. But I1 current, it is given in the problem as 2 amperes. If you simplify the expression, you will get I2 is equal to 3 amperes. So therefore, the current supplied by E2 source, it is the I2 current. Therefore, you answered the subdivision 2 of the problem. Current supplied by E2 source is I2, that is 2 amperes. Now we can answer the basically the solution for subdivision 1, because already I have done the simplification of the equation. You know that I1 plus I2 is 5 amperes. therefore value of E1 voltage is minus 2 become plus 2. I1 plus I2 is 5 ampere, when it is transferred to the right hand side it becomes plus 25, therefore E1 voltage becomes 27 volts. The subdivision 1. But at the same time you have to solve for the second voltage value E2. If we want to solve for the E2 voltage, create one more KVL equation for the closed loop DC EF D. So again the one more closed loop. DC EFD. D to C, if you travel, you are moving from minus to plus, it's a potential rise. Plus to minus becomes drop 2 times I2. What is I2? You know, it is 3 amperes. C to E, no element. If you move from E to F, plus to minus, it is a drop 5 times I1 plus I2, it is plus 5, equated to the zero value. Therefore, potential E2 will be 31 volts. So, the solution number 1 is the value of E1 and E2, current supplied by E2 source, it is calculated. The last part of the problem is terminal voltage or load voltage. Load it is going to receive I1 plus I2 ampere current, and current resistor value is 5 ohms, therefore load voltage or terminal voltage is 5 times I1 plus I2. Subdivision 3 is load voltage or terminal voltage. It is equal to 5 times I1 plus I2. 5 times 5, 25 volts. So this completes the fourth problem, and we are moving to the next variety. Question is, for the circuit shown, determine VAB subdivision 1 when the switch SC is closed. When the switch SC is kept open. First part of the problem is switch SC is closed. When switch SC is closed, potential at A is equal to potential at B. Therefore, there is no potential difference between A and B. VAB should be 0. The one possible solution. Or resistance offered across the AB terminal when switch is closed. Resistance offered by the short, it is zero, therefore you can name that as VAB zero. If you want to make the theoretical voltage measurement, assume the current as some I, which is delivered by 20 volt source. It is entering through the resistor and it is leaving. Write the simple KVL equation for the closed loop when switch S is closed. So therefore, if we travel from B to A, minus to plus, potential rise. Plus to minus becomes drop in potential, 1 times I, equated to the zero value. Therefore, I is equal to 20 amperes. Therefore, VAB potential is traveling from B to A, minus to plus become potential rise, plus to minus become drop in potential, 1 times I, it is 20 minus 1 times 20 equal to 0. So therefore, potential difference between A and B terminal when switch A is, S is closed, it is taken as 0. The second part of the problem is, switch S is kept open. Preferably, you remove the switch and you can mark the branch current. The current delivered by this source may be taken as I2. Call this current as some I1. Mark the polarity. Indicate this as I1 plus I2. Put the few more letters A, B, C, D and some F and G. So, the second part of the problem is switch S is kept open. Solve for one of the unknown known as I2, then preferably travel from B to A. So, you can write the two KVL equation for the two closed loops F, A, C, G, F. A, B, D, C, A. Now we will select the first closed loop, F, A. C, G, F. F to A, if you travel, plus to minus, it is a drop-in potential. Plus to minus, it is a drop-in potential. Minus to plus, rise in potential, equated to the zero value. 15 times I1, 5 times I2 is equal to 120. Go for the second closed loop, AB, DC, A. A to D, B, minus to plus, it is a potential rise, 1 times I2. Plus to minus, minus 20. Plus to minus, minus 100. C to A, minus to plus, it is a rise, 5 times I1 plus I2, equated to the 0 value. It is 5 times I1. 6 times I2 is equal to 120. Now, you got the two simultaneous equations in I1 and I2, preferably solve for I2 because that is the quantity which is needed for our work. You can go for Cramer's rule or you can solve the two simultaneous equations. Unknown currents are I1 and I2. Coefficient of I1 from equation number 1 is 15. Coefficient it is 5. Right hand side these 120, 5 times I1, 6 times I2 is equal to 120. Solve for the determinant of the resistance matrix, 15, 5, 5 and 6. This comes to 90 minus 25, it is 75 or 65, sorry. Therefore, solve for I2, where I2 current is replace the second column by right-hand side expression, 15 and 5 divided by determinant. It is 1800 minus 600 divided by 65, 1200 divided by 65, you'll be able to get this current as 18.46. Once if you know the value of I2, you can measure VAB. VAB is equal to move from B to A minus to plus, it is a rise. Plus to minus is a drop in potential 1 times I2. It is 20 minus 1 times 18.46. Value of voltage will be 1.54 volts. This completes the fifth problem. Preferably, we can move to the sixth variety. Determine subdivision 1. All the branch currents subdivision 2, current supplied by the source subdivision 3, equivalent resistance across the supply terminals, for the network shown. Problem can be solved through two different techniques. Check the given problem, whether it is a balanced bridge problem or an unbalanced bridge. Unbalanced bridge problem can be solved only through KCL KVL theory. But if the bridge is balanced, you can go for network reduction method. So, current delivered by and 10 volt source can be named as I1 plus I2. Current through the 9 ohm branch can be taken as I1. Current through the 6 ohm branch can be called as I2. Branch current through 10 ohm branch can be named as I3. Therefore, current flowing to the BC path, it is I1 minus I3. Current flowing through 2 ohm branch can be taken as I2 plus I3. Therefore, total current collected by the negative terminal is I1 plus I2 itself. So for the given problem, the network, it is a balanced bridge. If you multiply the product of the opposite arm resistances, you are going to get the same answer. 9 into 2 is 18, 6 into 3 is 18. Even after evaluating the problem, for a balanced bridge network, potential at B is equal to potential at D. When potential at B is equal to potential at D, I3 current, it automatically, it comes to the zero value, because two points are at the equipotential, potential difference is zero, current through the 10 ohm resistor is zero. Therefore, directly can answer the problem, I3 is zero, because the given network is a balanced Wheatstone bridge network. When the I3 current is zero, the network can be reduced to the simplest possible form like this. Nine ohm branch, that is in the AB terminal. Then from B to C, it is taken as 3 ohms. Then from A to D, you can call this as 6 ohm branch. This is 2 ohm resistor. Source resistance is 0.2 ohm. Battery voltage, it is 10. So two resistors are connected in series manner. Whether you name this is I1, this is I1 minus I3. When I3 is 0, current flowing through 9 ohm branch and 3 ohm branch, it is same because they are connected in series. 6 ohm branch and 2 ohm branch, it is connected in series. Two resistors are connected in series. These two resistors are connected in series. They are in turn connected in parallel. Therefore, I can replace this by a single resistance combination from the fundamental. 9 plus 3 becomes 12 ohms. 6 plus 2 becomes 8 ohms, which is in turn connected in series with 0.2 ohm source resistance, and source voltage will be 10 volts. Now, you have called this current as I1, you have named this current as I2, you have called the total current as I1 plus I2. But I1 plus I2 current can be called as some I, and your aim is to measure the total current. For that, two resistors are connected in parallel. It is connected in series with 0.2 ohm resistance. We are answering third subdivision of the question first, second subdivision of the question next, and last first subdivision of the question only at the end. What is the equivalent resistance, total resistance, or equivalent resistance of the combination is equivalent resistance across the supply terminal is ...12 ohm, 8 ohm resistors are connected in parallel. Their equivalent combination is 12 into 8 by 12 plus 8 in series with 0.2. That is 96 by 40 is 4.8 plus 0.2, 5 ohms. Now you can answer subdivision 2. Current supplied by the 10 volt source. So current supplied by 10 volt source is, it is I1 plus I2 ampere current, we call that as I. Just we know Ohm's law, total voltage by total resistance will be total current, 10 volts by 5 ohm, it is 2 amperes. Once if you know the current supplied by the source is 2 ampere, we are able to answer current to the 12 ohm branch and 8 ohm branch. Just you can apply current division method for subdivision 1. So therefore, branch currents are I1 current is total current supplied by the battery, it is I. If you have, when you are solving for the I1 branch current, take the opposite branch resistor I into 8 divided by 12 plus 8. I is 2, 2 into 8, divided by 20. That is 16 divided by 20, 0.8 amperes. Therefore, I2 current can be answered very easily, I minus I1 or I into 12 divided by 20. Therefore, it is 2 into 12 divided by 20, it is 1.2 amperes or 2 minus 0.8 is also equal to 1.2 amperes. Therefore, we can answer the problem for the subdivision 1 as IAB and IBC, they are same currents, it is equal to 0.8 amperes. Then IAD is equal to IDC is equal to I2 and its value will be 1.2 ampere. Current flowing through the 0.2 ohm branch is the total current, it is I 2 amperes. And current through BD branch is named as I3, it is already 0.